Like, one of my biggest problems is I always go for guys who are funny. Like, if you're not making me laugh, I'm not interested in you. I won't want to continue it.
There are single women with no kids who are college educated.
Yeah.
And they are having trouble finding mates because they're like, I'm at this level.
Yes.
And I'm looking for someone to elevate me, and I'm not finding a lot of candidates that are going to meet me or improve me. And I think that is what a lot of people are missing.
I think that's an excuse, though. There are educated women out there who can find good men, but the real question is, what they're not going to tell you is how many successful men that are on their level or above their level that they passed off for silly reasons.
That's true.
See, that's something they're not going to tell
you.
Yeah,
absolutely.
See, that's absolutely what we don't know. We just hear,
get to the nitty-gritty.
I can't find nobody.
But
no,
what did you
can
do
find
to
them.
Run him off?
Like, yeah, but you're not gonna hit right. But you're not gonna hear how many of those good successful
good
dudes
man
did enough. You turn down? How many did you not give your time to?
So that clip, I appreciate this sister, first of all. That clip was very interesting to hear. And women, when they see this, they're automatically going to go to, she's a pick me. And so many black women say that there aren't any eligible men out here. But I'm glad she said that and she's covering everything. Because women will only say one side. There are no men. There are no good men. All men are broke. They're in jail. They're gay. And I'm too successful. I can't find men to match me. There's no man as educated as I am. A man needs to have a degree to at least date me, so on and so forth. When a lot of you are a bill in itself, a lot of you bring debt, you will hang this degree up in the house. You'll post it. You'll have your photo shoots, all these things showing off your degree. But the debt that comes with it, you don't show that off. And you expect the man to take you on that may be at your level or higher. And it's not necessary. That's going to be out there for you, especially a man that's looking at you like, this is what it is. Men don't care about degrees. Men don't care about this stuff. A lot of you ladies, just in general, let's just say a lady that's not educated, but she's gorgeous. She's got a nice body. She prefers a certain type of dude. A woman's preference doesn't change. And this is one of those things. This is one of the reasons why only 28% are ever married, right? Only 28% of black women ever get married. That's a little over a fourth when you think about it. And I've posted about this, and women get upset, and they say in the comments on Facebook specifically, people don't understand math in general. Well, what about white women? Black people only make up 13% of the population. How could you say that? But this is relative. When it comes to these things, as opposed to the 50-something percent of white women will be married. And this has drastically dropped since the black family dynamic has basically been destroyed since how things were in the 60s and the 50s. But women are just too picky when it comes to that. And when I say picky, she said it perfectly that you'll overlook these guys who have a stable job. They may not be the baller or educated where you're at in terms of that, but they're holding things down. They'll treat you right. They're decent looking guys. But you're just like, I need the perfect thug. I need the perfect thug doctor that writes poetry. Like Carlos has said, Carlos was like, they can fight, write poetry, can dance, can do all these things all in one. And you feel like you deserve that. This guy needs to be a reflection of you and everything you like. He needs to be able to help you pay your student loans. He needs to be educated, have time for you, chase you. Don't chase you. Women just be all over the place talking stuff. And you saw how her face was just like, oh, whatever. But let's get into this next clip, which I think I played previously, where the woman said a good man just isn't enough. Let's jump into this, man. This is crazy.
Sometimes a woman can talk her out of a relationship. You can talk. We do that.
Yes.
We will talk.
I'm going to say something, and this might ruffle little feathers. I don't think just being a good man is enough. To stay in a relationship with them.
But when I say a good man, I mean like that means all around. That means himself, spiritually, mentally, physically.
That's great.
Healthily, like he's a good man.
That doesn't mean that he's the man for you. And
right.
Maybe when you're going through these motions of getting to know him, you're realizing, okay, he's a great person, but honestly, I don't fuck with his humor. Like, he could be funny, but he's not funny to me.
And that's why a lot of modern women are getting 40 with four cats and no man, because
maybe that's what
he's
they
a
like.
Good. He's a good man, but because he's not funny, you gotta throw that out.
These women just be saying like some of the dumbest stuff. Rest in peace to Kevin, though. They just be saying the dumbest stuff. All those things you see, they were checking him off at the bottom. He can have this, but I just don't mess with his humor. He's boring. He's not funny, which I
just finished my workout at the gym, so we're just gonna ignore how I look. But I want to go back to like one of my problems with dating, and I realized that like one of my biggest problems is I always go for guys who are funny. Like, if you're not making me laugh, I'm not interested in you. I won't want to continue it. But like the guys who are funny are always assholes, and they're always like emotionally unavailable. Like, why is that? And then the guys who are like super nice and would like treat me right and like give me the whole world, they're just not funny. And I can't click with you if you're not funny. And like, that's my problem.
Which I get it. If you feel like a guy's boring, boring is safe. Safe is boring to a lot of women. They want some excitement, some adventure. They want a man that they have to think about, worry about, complain to their girlfriends about. That's what it boils down to. And that's why you don't care about security in that matter. You sometimes care if he makes money, but it's right. A woman's preference doesn't change, fellas. And that's what I'd like you guys to know. This woman right here, she's an attractive woman. So she pretty much has her pick of men. She has a decent body. I had some women commenting on my Facebook when I posted, why does a woman's body, and this is a video similar to this, why does a woman's body matter? Next, you're going to, the same thing with looks. Why does her looks matter? Because her looks do matter to a certain extent. It's not the end all be all, because a lot of pretty women have the worst attitudes. They have the worst minds when it comes to this. But we're just speaking as a whole. This is why a lot of black women aren't married, because of this. Because they feel like they're settling. They'll waste their good years on or get pregnant by the pookies who aren't about nothing. There's a lot of trauma that comes with this. And this is just the entitlement overall that turns some, any man who knows his value and knows that, hey, this woman's a problem right off top. I can clap the cheeks and dip, but it sounds like she's a problem off top. I'm not getting anything out of this but a headache. And sometimes you can find this out early on with women like this. I just need a man that has his master's. He needs to at least have his master's to date me. For me to take him seriously, he has to have his master's. And this goes on. There's so many videos I get into, especially the educated is even worse. Not to say a woman shouldn't be educated, but the fact that she feels like she has to have her equal. Men will date down. Women feel like they have to date up or equal. But one thing I always say as well, and this is something that tends to happen, is that money and education goes to your head where you feel like you can disrespect the man. And that's not cool. Any man who's centered and grounded, he would never allow that. A real man, that education, well, most men just in general, that education holds no weight, baby. That plaque, that degree, whatever have you, none of that holds any weight to a man. That doesn't make you a good person. It just means that you could sit there in a classroom and learn some things and repeat it. That's all it is, baby. Anyway, guys, let me know what you guys think about this whole situation. Comment below, like, share, comment, and subscribe. Much blessings in abundance. Stick around for the next video that's going to pop up on the screen below. That's where I'm going to see you guys at. It's your favorite everything. This is Wisdom. I'm out of here. Peace.